When ICES talks about ecosystem-based management, it's what we recognize as the primary way to manage human activities in the marine environment. And ecosystem-based management is about three things. It's about ecosystem health and status. It's about human and societal health and status. And it's also about the ability to achieve what we want in terms of ecosystem and human health and societal health.
IEA Integrated Ecosystem Assessment is a tool that we use to try and fulfill some of the goals of ecosystem-based management. So if we want to deliver on it, we have to have ways of doing that. So for doing that, we have a cycle, essentially, where we go out and work with stakeholders of different types. They could be from the industry, they could be scientists, policymakers, managers, all of those, to identify what are the priorities for the system that we're looking at. Essentially, what are the questions that they need answers to? From that, then, we can prioritize and try and narrow down what it is that we need to know, what information we have, what information we're missing, and then try and do things like use modeling tools and trends analysis so that we can have an idea of what trends are going on in our ecosystem, so we can identify warning signals, we can see where the biggest risk in our system is, essentially, so that we can manage to them. Because ecosystem-based management is so all-encompassing and takes everything in, but we are limited in our capacity to what we can deliver. So we have to do some kind of prioritization to identify what it is that's most important for us to focus on.
If we were to look for examples in terms of ecosystem health, I think it's about indicators and working out with stakeholders and society where they want a threshold to be in terms of those indicators, such as how many fish of a certain type do you want in a certain area? What kind of fishery do you want in terms of forage fish? Those kind of questions. In terms of human health, we're already in some of the ecosystem overviews looking at vulnerable communities. And in our aquaculture overviews, we're looking at some of the social and economic important issues for aquaculture development. And in terms of the ability to govern and to deliver ecosystem-based management, we're working with people like DG Environment to ensure that our evidence flow is fit for purpose into their decision-making processes.
The main challenge for this kind of work is the scale of integration that we need. We're looking at, as I mentioned, numerous different industries, numerous different types of pressures, which takes numerous different types of scientists as well, and different managers. And a lot of these things traditionally are managed in very siloed ways. And we're, I mean, clues in the name, trying to integrate all of that. And so we're trying to learn how to work in these multidisciplinary and transdisciplinary teams where, social scientists and economists and natural scientists are all coming together and learning each other's language, because we don't get our educations in the same way either. So sometimes we can think we're talking about the same thing and we're not. So this all presents a challenge. Possibly even more than that is the resources. We really need this work to be funded at a core level so that we can advance it and make it part of the advice. If we need ecosystem-based advice the same way as we have stock assessment advice, that kind of thing, then we need the same structures in place to be able to support that work so that we can compete and we can give the necessary information for sustainable management of our ocean resources moving forward.
A key component of ecosystem-based management is understanding that the objectives are set by society, by politicians, and we have to work to provide the evidence and in fact consider the certainty of that evidence and put it into a risk framework and think about the trade-offs between those objectives. So for instance, if you're to look at the coastal or the shelf seas in Europe, we have wind parks now, we have conservation objectives in terms of biodiversity recovery, and we have fisheries. And those three are all now wanting space or the rights to have their activities. And ICES is about trying to reconcile those objectives through a risk-based framework. By using the ecosystem overviews, we've already started prioritizing what are the main challenges in each of the ecoregions in ICES. So we already think of that in terms of broader EBM. But we've also, with our analysis of bottom trawling and also the understanding of bycatch and vulnerable marine ecosystems, we've started to develop processes with stakeholder engagement and with iterative dialogue with the managers to ensure that we bring together those elements of ecosystem health and human health, and also the ability to achieve. And that's hopefully going to become stronger and more developed as we look to the future. A key part that we do more than people understand is we already think about, in terms of our single stock advice, we already build a lot of ecosystem trends into that advice. I think it's well over 60% of our data-rich stocks have some element of trends from the ecosystem in it. So that makes sure that our advice responds to the changes.